So this will be a weekly series, hopefully, where I gear a monk by myself only using pugs. As you can see, I've done the tutorial Torghast Lair and I picked Kyrian, but everything else I have not done. I'm gonna start by buying some BOEs. As a side note, I didn't end up buying a cape or a necklace because those pieces get filled by the tutorial Torghast quests. Now that we have a nice baseline of gear, we're going to try to find a group and you'll see how that goes. We're going to start off by trying to get into a Mythic Zero. Now, I don't know if they'll invite me. I'm kind of low item level, but if I can get in, that's cool. If not, that sucks. Right, so clearly I'm not getting accepted to these. As you can see, I got declined from everything, so I just went and made my own group instead, which is almost always easier. So I'm back at my sanctum to grab my callings because I'm very behind on renown, and I'm pretty sure most of these should give renown. And it's not like we're doing much else while we're waiting for a group. Alright, we got a full group. Still not very good at the weapons of order rotation, but I'll have to get used to it. It reminds me of playing with Serenity, which I never liked. No TG proc, sad, sad, sad. Let's just join this random guild. Forgot I have no HP. But this guild has like 1,000 people in it. Maybe when I get some more gear, I can bum a raid off of them. Damn. Literally all of us got the haste debuff. Wow. I don't know if this is gonna be so great. Fire Mage with Keystone Master is currently combusting the boss that's taking 75% reduced damage. You'll love to see it. They don't know that there are tentacles here. Okay, cool. See if the mage does the mirror images. My hard read is that he's going to combust and pull, and I'm not going to be able to get my damage off. So I'm just going to let him have his fun, and then I'll do my cooldowns in the second phase. Since we're probably going to pop all our cooldowns in first. Even with me popping my cooldowns by myself, I was still not able to get everything done. I need to target something first. They got a renown. That's nice. Let's see if he needs a cape. He does. Ooh, that guy got the sword. I'm jealous. Cool, got the sword. Don't have it offhand. So we end our first dungeon with two pieces of loot, a ring and a main hand.
We start working on the campaign, which nets us a legs upgrade and Clea's soulbind.
Alright, we got our renown from that and a quest to do Spires of Ascension, so seems pretty clear which dungeon we should do next. Hey, I don't need heal. This group filled up very quickly. In pain. I have a feeling this isn't going to go so great. Like, I've done Mythic Zeros with no healer. I've done Keys with no healer. But I have a feeling that the quality of player is going to be very much not as good as in those groups. I'm kind of afraid of this boss.
I didn't explain it in the recording, but the reason I was afraid of this boss was because of Darkstride. 15 second bleed with no healer is kind of hard to deal with, even on a Mythic Zero.
Yeah, but it does see no this one. I don't know how I was in combat. I mean, I wasn't in combat, but someone else was. Just die, bro.
Ironically, it was my skip that caused problems this time around. But this time, it was the tank's turn to try an ambitious skip. This skip goes bad really quickly, with somehow the shaman pulling all three packs we were trying to skip.
Sometimes I feel like skips are not worth it. That rebellious, oh my god, everything gold.
And now it's my turn to make a dumb hero move. I tried to use the spear so that we could get through this pole without anyone dying, but I forgot the Hellion still shoots out damage to the entire party when the spear is active, so I just kind of wasted the spear for no reason. In the end, the tank ended up surviving and finishing the pack by himself, so maybe the spear wasn't so bad after all.
Aww.
The tank pulls Clotos first, which sets me into a full panic, but then I realize we're in a Mythic Zero, so it doesn't really do that much damage. But never pull it like this, please.
Actually, it doesn't do that much damage. It's like the worst order to pull these in.
One of the main reasons I was kind of concerned with not having a healer for this dungeon was also Devos. Because while Darkstride is one person taking a bleed that they're likely going to die from, Devos puts a dot on the entire party during her intermission, which just kind of rotted us down for the rest of the fight.
Is that the plan? Just res everyone? I don't think we're gonna have enough reses. Is our hero gonna try to solo this? Yep, you sure will. You can't jump over that. Honestly, you might be able to if he lives this dot. She's probably not gonna. Yeah, he's not gonna. Ooh. Can he do it? Oh, he's Venthyr. Big damage. Oh, he's gonna try to... Wow. He's gonna try to live it again. I mean, it does no da- Oh! He didn't use the defensive that time. He had a charge of Survival Instincts, he just didn't use it. Please use Survival Instincts, oh god. He used it after and he gets hit- Oh. Oh, he's actually just done. Why didn't he use anything? Oh, it's dead. It didn't reset yet, so just it died. That's cool. You have my thanks. Gotta yoink some gear. You know, a world boss would probably help. How did I forget about that? Didn't even get a renown. Oh, I did get a renown. Okay. You are a true protector of Ardenweald. That laggy mess was interesting.
So we finished up a lot. We got another dungeon done, which helped us get our story quest complete. We got another renown from the world boss. And we got some more gear. We have another story mission to do, and probably some more mythic dungeons before the end of the week. Alright, so the video's over, but I have a bunch more footage. I didn't want to make the video too long, so I'm going to separate it into a separate video, and hopefully that'll be out pretty soon. Thanks for watching!